Dear friends, this is Prithvi Raj from Bangalore connecting with you once again through this short message on salvation. In Romans 1:18, we read that the wrath of God is being revealed from heaven against all the godlessness and wickedness of people. In Bible, we come across many incidents manifesting the wrath of God against His people for their disobedience. God's wrath is the response of His holiness and righteousness towards evil and towards intrusion of evil into His world. Someone said that the wrath of God is His steady, unrelenting, unremitting, uncompromising hostility to evil in all its forms and manifestations. Bible informs us about the day of judgment, and we are under the condemnation of God because of our rebellion and disobedience. Our sins separate us from God, and the consequence of our sin is death. The divine wrath hangs over us unless or until it is taken away. Though the wrath of God is mentioned several times in the Bible, it is also counteracted by the theme of salvation. In Romans 5:8-9, we read that God demonstrates His own love for us in this. While we were still sinners, Christ died for us. Since we have now been justified by His blood, how much more shall we be saved from God's wrath through Him? In Romans 3:23, we read that without salvation we are dead in our sins. In John 3:14 onwards, we are told that without salvation we are condemned. And in John 3:36, we read that without salvation we are under God's wrath. From Romans 5:9 and 1 Thessalonians 5:9, we understand that salvation refers to being saved from wrath of God, that is, from God's judgment of sin. Thus, salvation refers to the deliverance from eternal punishment for sin. We are reconciled to God through Christ. God has rescued us from the penalty of sin through the blood of Christ. In 1 John 2:2, we read that Christ is the atoning sacrifice for our sins and for the sins of the whole world. Salvation is the gift of God and is given freely to all who truly believes in the finished work of Jesus Christ on the cross. In Acts 4:12, we are told that there is no other name under heaven given to mankind by which we must be saved. Christ is the only way for salvation. We are lost without Christ. Faith in the redemptive work of Jesus Christ and life of obedience to God go together. Believing in Christ, repenting from our rebellion, confessing our sins, and accepting Christ as our Savior is the starting point of our new life in Christ. Salvation from the punishment of sins is also called justification, which means the God's act of removing the guilt and penalty for sin and making a sinner righteous through Christ's atoning sacrifice. In Bible, salvation is also understood as ongoing process. we are being saved from the power of sins, and this process is called sanctification. We are being conformed to the likeness of Lord Jesus Christ. And the salvation process goes on till our departure from earth. In Matthew 24:13, we read that one who stands firm to the end will be saved. We need to withstand the trials patiently and has to overcome the temptations on a regular basis. In our pluralistic society, we have made the concept of God user-friendly and derived a convenient doctrine that God is only love and would never punish sin. But the truth is, God will judge all who have never repented and trusted in Christ. In order to escape the wrath of God, we have to receive the salvation that is given freely to whoever believes in the redemptive work of Christ and consistently follow Him through their conscious efforts. Thank you for listening. May God bless you.